Okay, everyone. So I had some small problems with my Stryker airplane a couple weeks ago. What happened was I was flying it, and this whole motor mount here just twisted and snapped off. So what I did was I went out and I got another motor mount and I installed it. The prop busted completely on both sides, but for some reason there's just no damage, you know, on that side or this side there. There's really no damage. So I'm not really sure what happened, but I know the motor was hanging when it came down and the prop was totally snapped off. But what I want to show you guys today was something I picked up from my local hobby shop is the new Stryker. So this is the Stryker Q. I didn't really want to do an unboxing of it because those aren't very fun, but just a quick once around magnetic front. I'm probably going to tape it or hook it there some other way. I did epoxy down the rudders into the foam here. They said they give you double-sided tape and tell you you could CA it if you're going to be doing some crazy stuff. So I just epoxied it down. It sits nice with those black things right there and then the wheel in the front. So that's a real wheel. It spins. Kind of cool. It definitely feels more rigid and stronger and definitely ready to take a beat in here. But the problem that I have is that I bought the plug-and-play version and I'm trying to figure out how to get my receiver to stay in there. If we see, this is the inside of the Stryker Q. What they give you is this. It's the eFlight EFL A1040. It's the 40-amp BEC. It does come with a switch on it here, so that was kind of interesting that there's a switch so you can turn it on and off when the battery is connected to it. So it sits in this general area here, and it gets tied down by those Velcro tabs right underneath it. This goes back to the motor. But I'm not really sure how the receiver goes here. So I have a AR500 here. And the way I did the other one was I drilled a hole directly down and I ran the wire down and along the back side. And I think I might do the same for this. But these wires from the elevators, or the ailerons rather, are really short. So I'm not really sure how I'm going to wrap this in there. That's kind of what's cool about the bind and fly is that they already come all put together so you don't have to worry about this. But, and what's funny too is that there's no real references or documentation online to show you a picture of the inside of a Stryker 27Q yet. So hopefully, maybe one of you guys can help me out with that or at least show me a video, do a response video of the inside of your new Stryker 27Q bind and fly so I could take a look at it and just see how they routed it through there. But other than that, everything's going really well. Can't wait to get this guy up in the air. It takes the same 3-cell 2200 milliamp hour battery and it goes faster, they say, so I'm really dying to get it up in the air. I'm also happy to get the Stryker back because this is quickly becoming one of my favorite planes to fly. It's just a real eye catcher. It runs real hot, and I just love to fly it. On this one here, I did cut the sides off. So these used to be the big protruding, like, fake vent sides and on each side there. And what I did was I kind of cut, notched out the edge right there so it's not hitting a brick wall. The wind's not hitting it hard and then having to go around it. It's kind of just deflecting now on both sides. So I'm going to see how that goes. I'm really happy with this Stryker, and I know I'm going to be really happy with the new one. So that's about it for now. I should have a flight video up of the new one here pretty quick. And hope you guys enjoy my videos, and happy flying. Willy, Willy, Willy.